What can you tell us about your character and what fans can expect in terms of her introduction?
Hey, my character is Zari. She's from the future. She's from 2030. She is going to meet the legends in 2030, and she's a woman who speaks her mind. She's powerful. She is a hacker, an activist, and she's sort of seen the fallout from some events that started in 2017, the rise of populism, the refugee crisis, and you know, she's encountered and has experienced this very bleak future, and so she sort of philosophically thinks that the legends should not just fix history, they should improve history. So they don't exactly see eye to eye at the beginning, but it's going to be, the journey of the season is going to be, you know, finding out how she becomes part of the team.
I'm curious off of that. How is she going to, with Nate, you know, like, since he's a historian, it's all about kind of preserving it. So how are them two going to interact? And are they going to have a lot of headbutting?
That's a good question. I don't know exactly with Nate, but that would make sense. I think she's going to butt heads with a lot of the legends. And I know that she and Ray are going to have, again, just like, I think they're philosophically different. Zari is not the glass half empty quite, but definitely Ray is the glass half full. So I think she's really gonna challenge the legends to, you know, at the end of last season, but at the end of some of the seasons, like, there's a little bit of like, we did it, you know, and
for a split moment,
for like a second, and then usually someone, in this case me, is like, actually the future is terrible, and like, you guys did not fix everything, and so yeah, she's I think gonna be challenging to them, and then, you know, ultimately part of the team, which will be interesting to watch that.
Your character is Muslim, and with all the choice of you know, heroes that they could play and bring into the show, do you feel that the choice of bringing ISIS into the show is because of the times that we're living in?
I can't speak for Phil or Mark, and I will say that we have decided to leave the name of ISIS behind because it seemed like the sensible thing to do in our current climate. And there's gonna, of course, that character will be informed by that. I think it's a really amazing opportunity. I think it's a I really commend Phil and Mark for choosing to bring a character like this, who, you know, she's just like us, you know. And I think normalizing a Muslim American character, a character that's just as American as she is Muslim, I think that's really a powerful thing to do right now on television and in media, and important.
And then with that, oh, sorry. will you be going with the legends to go back in time, where like others sometimes, like, where Jackson's like, oh, not a good area for me, you know, not a good time for me. Is that gonna come?
That's a good question. I wonder. I think. Her being Muslim American is a part of the many things that she is, a tapestry of the person that she is. But I'll be interested to see. I don't know, like, how it's going to play into, I don't know.
Yeah, like, going. Most of the cast, they can go anywhere, they can do anything, and right. It's like they can pretty much assimilate into whatever they're going to do.
Yeah, no, it's going to be interesting to see, like, what time period you're challenging for her.
Yeah.
There's a comic book history to her. There's also a couple of different ways television interpretations of her. Do you delve into any of that? Or because you've left the name behind, do you feel a little freer in leaving a lot of the stuff that exists?
Yeah,
in that
you know, but I think it's so cool about what, like, the whole Arrowverse has done, is because they have a lot of time to develop these characters, the characters kind of become their own thing. And so I'm sort of planning to take, like, what is helpful to me in creating, like, my version of Zari, and I think Mark and Phil are doing a similar thing, and I'm sort of excited to see, you know, what we come up with for the Legends version of Zari. But I'm doing as much research as feels sort of helpful and not hurtful.
The character is also like from a few years in the future.
Yeah, 2030.
So, yes. So have you, you know, like, thought about what would you like in that time?
Yeah. Gosh, it's a little scary to think about, and from what I know, it's not a great future. I have been thinking about it without getting like too dark. I've sort of been exploring in my imagination, you know, what's sort of the worst version of where we're headed, you know, and as hard as that it is to imagine, it's kind of scary to imagine. I think it's going to be helpful through my work. You know, actually, it's like writing. I should think more about that even. Yeah.